So now we have the main event, the third fight of the evening, the second Muay Thai bout, second world title bout for the IMC. It's the super welterweight division, and it's Niclas Larsen against Carsten Ringler. Niclas Larsen is now inside of the ring, and we all know him. We all love his fights. They're always so much action. He was newcomer of the year by Glory. He's a great fighter. And now you can see his walking. Awesome fighter. Really good clincher. I think this will be a great, really great matchup. Niclas Larsen, the striker on the distance, and Carsten Ringler on the inside, the striker, the powerhouse. You can see he extra did green hair, like Joker for this fight. It's the Joker style. He's trying to come inside here and try to win this world title. And it's Ralf Stege, legendary Ralf Stege in this corner. Multiple champion in multiple divisions in his time, and way better as a fighter was he as a coach. Now the Vaikru will start, a traditional ritual of the Muay Thai sport, which shows the dedication of the fighter, not just to the sport, but to his family, his friends, his coaches. And Carsten Ringler is doing the Vaikru from the Khe Somrit gym in Bangkok, for which he fought at the Max Muay Thai promotion in Pattaya. And even though he's hardly ever training with the same coach or always training pretty much under his own lead, he still shows his respect to the crew, the coach. And he also has lots of experience as a coach himself. He's the coach of UFC fighter Khalid Taha. He's the striking coach. And on the other side, we see the Vaikru by Niclas Larsen. Muay Thai enthusiast, really so many experiences during his career, so many special events, Glory newcomer of the year, Glory tournaments, and Muay Thai titles in the Danish divisions, in the European divisions, and in the world divisions. And in his corner, his crew for this fight is not a crew, it's a Zifu. That means it's a Chinese boxing coach. It's Martin Brogard, and from Extreme Muay Thai. He coached Niclas Larsen to show him some new special things from a different sport, to maybe increase his ability by showing him something else from outside, something new. So now we will start. And it's Carsten Ringler in the red corner and Niclas Larsen in the blue corner. So let's see who wins this, the clincher or the striker. Oh, and Niclas Larsen starts quick. Jab, uppercut, and right into the clinch. That's where Carsten feels well. But this clinch, Niclas dominated with the knees. Oh, beautiful left knee to the body. Another beautiful left knee to the body. And a beautiful turn. Beautiful, beautiful jab. Beautiful right hook by Larsen. And a beautiful jumping knee. Oh, nice sweep. Great clinch. You can see the respect of each fighter for the other one. Beautiful knee to the liver by Larsen. how Larsen just stepped out of the jab, and the face of Carsten is already showing marks. Nice punch combination by Larsen. Another nice punch as a counter to the low kick. A nice elbow by Larsen. Nice knee to the body by Larsen. Oh, nice Chinese boxing techniques, but also nice knees by Ringler. Ringler just needs a second to find his pace, but Larsen won't give him the space to do so. Nice low kick by Ringler, but Carsten again, but Larsen again straight into the clinch. Nice knees by Ringler in the clinch. Great. Oh, nice low kick. Two nice low kicks by Carsten, but Larsen caught him and let him fall. So, oh, Larsen's just dominating now with a punch combination, but Ringler is trying to find knees. So, just two low kicks blocked by Larsen. He's having fun in here. He's dominating. Doesn't see that Carsten is doing the same. But it's Muay Thai, it's a 5-round bout. So who knows what happens. Nice punch combination by both of them, but now a nice counter punch again against the low kick, and a nice sweep by Larsen. Wonderful, wonderful display of techniques. Wonderful display of techniques. This is textbook style Muay Thai. This is beautiful. And the first one is over. So now we have to see how legendary fighter Ralf Steger can adjust the style of Carsten in this break. So just as a side information, Niclas had a lot of adversaries he had to face during his career. He had long injuries, two of them. The last year he was out because of due to a hand injury. Before that, he had a leg injury due to a staph infection. He had to learn walking again, which took him 2 years. But you can't see it. He's seem not faced by any of that. He told me in the interview before the fight that it just made him stronger instead of weaker. And on the other hand, Carsten Ringler is also well experienced. He's fighting since 2007, has tons of experience, fought in Thailand, and told me like the most beautiful experience in his fighting career was fighting in Thailand at Max Muay Thai in Pattaya, and just preparing for the fight in Bangkok. And I think all of us Muay Thai trainees or enthusiasts and fighters know how that feels like, just being able to dedicate everything you have to the sport you love. Now it's the second round, and Carsten's starting quicker. Nice jab and low kick. Nice knee by Carsten in the clinch, but Larsen's putting him into the corner, and then they brawl. Nice punch combination by Niclas. Nice knees by Niclas. Oh, four knees in a row. A knee counter by Carsten. Oh, nice elbow by Carsten. Didn't expect that. But Niclas is not leaving Carsten any space to work, to find his pace. Niclas is steadily pushing towards him, steadily pressuring him. And this is the second round. This is usually a slow round in Muay Thai. But Niclas is not abiding to that unofficial law. But nice punch. Nice punch by Carsten. You can also already see a cut on Carsten's face. Nice sweep by Larsen. Nice cut. There's a cut on the face of Carsten now. And it's already getting bigger and thicker. So now the wing doctor will be taken into consideration, and he has to say if Carsten can still fight. So hopefully he can fix it now, quick, and then he can fight on. So Carsten says it's okay, he can fight. He doesn't care about the cut. So it seems like the doctor gave us okay and went off again. So now the coach, Ralf Steger, is just putting in some Vaseline. Oh. Ooh! Nice flying punch by Carsten. A Superman punch. Nice low kick. Nice sweep by Larsen. Nice low kick by Ringler. Oh, nice uppercut by Ringler. But Larsen just threw him away. And the coach said the uppercut, it landed, and yes, it landed. But Larsen is dominating him now again with the boxing techniques. I think Larsen also has a cut above his eye. Oh, it's the blood of Ringler. But nice clinching that they show you. Oh, cut above the eye of Larsen. By an elbow I didn't even see coming. So Ringler's showing a lot of heart here, and it seems like he's slowly taking over a bit, taking back the fight into his terms. Yeah, it seems like the doctor gave us okay again, so now it's 1-1 with a cut. The coach is just putting on some Vaseline again, and now the fight goes on. I can't wait to see more action, more violence. And the second round is over. Beautiful round by both fighters. But Larsen was dominating the clinch game and everything, but you could see that Carsten was able to slip in some techniques, like the elbow, which cut open Larsen's face. You could see the difference of both of the rounds, which is due to the adjustment of the fighter himself and additionally of the coach. And now we will see how much they can adjust in this break. So now the doctor had something to say to the ref. I think he wants to have another look at the eye of Larsen. Or no, he's going back to his place, back to his chair. But that's it. There are elbows in Muay Thai. Now I can't wait for the third round to start. Larsen can face another adversary in this opponent, like he faced so many adversaries in his life. With Ringler will be taken over this fight. Oh, nice punch combination. Nice punches to the back of the head. Oh, nice, another nice elbow by Larsen. Nice punches. Nice knee by Larsen. It seems like the strategy of the first round that he's going back in. Oh, nice punch, and I think that hit Ringler hard. He's not so stable on his foot at the moment, and the coaches tell him just stay calm, and that's what he did. And so it worked out. And now a nice flying elbow, but Ringler just gave an elbow on his own. And now I think the knee of Larsen to the head just put Ringler down. And Ringler has heart. He shows heart. He shows that he wants to fight. And now he's getting back at it. Yeah, nice heaps by by Ringler and all of them worked. Oh, nice upward elbow. And the coach threw in the towel. Ringler's out by an elbow, upward elbow by Larsen. Congratulations to the new champ, Niclas Larsen, and thanks a lot to both of the fighters for this beautiful fight. So yeah, Niclas Larsen is the new IMC world champion in the super welterweight division. There's the Danish flag flying in the blue corner. Ringler just excused himself to his opponent for getting knocked out, and that's just how much heart he has. So now we just wait for the doctors to get inside of the ring to take a look at Carsten Ringler and look if he has to go into the hospital or something. And we have the official now inside of the ring to hand over the title belt to Niclas Larsen, the new world champion in the super welterweight division of the IMC. So now the referee is asking both of the fighters to the center of the cage and to the center of the ring. And we will declare the official knockout now.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Muay Thai World Championship of the IMC International Muay Thai Council comes to an end. And the winner is Niclas Larsen because of technical
knockout. So we just heard the official. Official conclusion, Niclas Larsen won the IMC belt due to a technical knockout. Beautiful defeat, beautiful fight by both fighters. Also a beautiful fight by Carsten Ringler. So maybe just tune in to the post-fight interview I will have with the winner, Niclas Larsen, afterwards. Just stay on and watch it. Thanks for a great fight. Congratulations on winning the IMC world title. And man, first of all, I was surprised a little bit because I expected the fighter that strikes a lot. But you, it was different to former fights of you where you striked a lot and tried to fight out the distance. Now you went inside a lot. You showed a different side of your fighting style. Can you tell us something about that, maybe?
Well, first of all, thank you very much. I'm so glad to fight on this great event. Day of Destruction made it very, very great for me. And I must say that to be back after 1 year and to try new stuff, I feel I still develop as a fighter, and that's very important for me. So that's why I was more fighting on the close distance. It was a bit hard for me because I think the gloves was a little bit bigger than I expected, but that's okay. I think I tried some new things, and it went my way, and I got a little bit stressed with the headbutt.
Headbutt?
Yeah, it was a headbutt. So because we went in the clinch and then it could stop the fight, and I would be very sad because for me. It was all about tonight. Was all about how I could be back in the ring and show my new skills and develop. And I have so much more to come, and I'm very excited to be back. So that was great.
Yeah, thanks again for this beautiful fight.
Thank
and
you.
Congratulations on the title. And I hope you have the opportunity to celebrate a lot tonight, or at least as much as possible during these circumstances. Do you want to say hello or greet somebody, maybe say thank you?
I want to say thank you to so many people. I have all the guys from Extreme Muay Thai back in Denmark. I have all my loved ones. I can go on the list. They know who they are. I have my team today that really showed me that they believe in me, and they use so much time on me. Martin Brogaard, my head coach, who trained Chinese boxing with me, believe in this new system that we developed together, Smarter Fighter, we call it. It's going to be so amazing to bring this game to a new level. And of course, there's so many people. That's the thing, that I'm not alone. I'm fighting in the ring, and I'm taking all the hits. But again, I have so many people that support me and get me to where I am. So I'm very, very glad and appreciate. Thanks to Ralph, the promoter for this event, and Fire. Amazing! They have the guts to make this happen, yeah. And I haven't fought for 1 year,
yeah.
And now they create opportunity. So thank you so much to the Day of Destruction as well. I'm very, very glad to be here, and I hope to come back again.
Thank you, and have a nice evening, and I
thank
hope
you.
To see you soon.
Thank you so much, Jensen. Thank you.
Thanks.